UK Sports for this Thursday afternoon game. Now the starting group for the visitors. And for Denver.
Well, Denver has always been such a difficult place to play because of the altitude, because of the fact the Nuggets have been pretty good. Last year, Denver not able to dominate at home, mainly because of injuries. They really had a disjointed season.
And Denver has possession. Number 16, he's on target from 8 feet out.
You know, he's not somebody they lean on for points, but when he does score, that's a bonus.
That is dominant. You're right, Steve, as in the past Denver was at home, what, 20 and 13. That's a good mark at home, but just not perhaps what Nugget fans might be used to. And Clark, you know, that altitude, Steve was just talking about that, always kind of plays a factor with the visiting team coming into the Mile High City.
It's a home court advantage for sure in more ways than one. If you look at the direction of the Nuggets and how they've been able to stay competitive, Kevin, while rebuilding on the fly, I think the Nuggets have to be happy with how they've been playing at home.
That is good. We're about 1 minute into the first. Number 13. And he misses his first shot of the game.
Tell you what, he can be really frustrating as a shooter. All you can do is grimace because you just can't find the range.
Off the mark and a bad shot there. Just around a minute and a half into the first quarter. Down low, number 7 goes up and lays it nice and easy.
Well, every once in a while, he'll show us some pretty good moves around the hoop.
The Nuggets have gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Yes, Kevin, thanks. I caught up with the Nuggets head coach. We talked about their strategy defensively, going up against such an explosive offense. He said, well, we've done our advanced scouting. We know where it is they like to get their shots and where they're most effective. The challenge is taking that information and using it out on the court. It's a great test for our players, and I'm eager to see how they respond. It'll be fun for us to watch, Kevin.
Thanks, Doris, and pretty prudent approach, I think, guys, considering the offensive explosiveness they have to contend with here.
Definitely, Kevin. You have to have a very specific plan of attack when you play against a club like this one.
And even then, guys, adjustments need to be made at some point, and that's guaranteed. I mean, it's always a chess match against this team.
Nuggets have gone 3-4 from the field to start out the game. Number 14. Again, the Nuggets score.
This has been the start that they had hoped for, coming out knocking down 4 of their first 5 shots.
Here in the first, just under 2.5 minutes played so far. Number 7. It's hauled in by the Nuggets.
Tipped.
All by himself. Number 11. That drops.
Well, for him, that finger roll is almost second nature. That's a tough shot for most players.
Now about 3 minutes gone in the first quarter. Pulls up. High post. Drained for 2 points. He's got 6. The visitors with the ball. They trail by 1. To the middle. Good ball movement here by the Nuggets. Number 11 drills the 3-pointer. First quarter play, and just over 3.5 minutes in. number 17. Again, the Nuggets score.
That offense just keeps on clicking.
It sure does, Clark. They're getting high percentage looks and really taking advantage here.
Shot clock at 6. No luck on the running jump shot. The Nuggets leading by 6. To the inside. And they're pushing it up. Number 11. That one goes. Come. Timeout is called. First of the game for the Nuggets. Both teams will make substitutions. The Nuggets have gone 7 of 8 from the field to start the game. Very hot shooting. Number 4, covered by Hamilton. Number 5, sweet little floater.
How about that cloth soft touch? I mean, just a gentle little teardrop, almost like a falling leaf. A leaf falling down slowly to the ground. Very sweet and colorful, too.
Number 13, rebound by the Nuggets.
Well, the effort was there, but he just couldn't quite fight his way through traffic.
Number 5. And that is good.
Nice soft touch to drop that one in.
Gone 5 of 9 from the field here in the first. Number 7. On target from 13 feet. He has 7. The Nuggets leading by 6. Number 4, using his post move to get the 2 points. Gone 6 of 10 from the field in this ballgame. Number 11, off target with the open look. Denver's gone 1 of 2 from long range in the first quarter. A minute 50 left to play in the first quarter. Number 11. Off target there, that would have pushed the lead to double digits. And they're on the break. Number 11. Count that one.
Boy, they are really getting chewed up inside here. I mean, that's 8 of the last 10 points they've given up inside, in the paint.
Yeah, and the paint should be sacred ground for a defense. I mean, you can't let anybody just trot in there and get an easy bucket.
And it's the Nuggets with the ball. 6-point game. He's off from 17 feet.
You know, that mid-range jump shot is not his strong suit, even when he gets a good look like that.
There's the pass to Hamilton. Just 5 on the clock. Number 11. The shot is off. Now the Nuggets take it the other way. Inside. Gathers. There's 47 seconds left in the first quarter. Number 4 gets it to go.
He was not to be denied that time, guys. Fought his way to the glass and came up with the points.
The Nuggets leading by 4. Number 6. And again, Denver no good.
Yeah, that's a low percentage shot right there.
Yeah, it sure is. I mean, he's got to be thinking out there a little better. Make the pass in that situation. Don't force a bad shot.
Hits the bucket. He's got 6.
Nice, aggressive, defensive play to make the steal and start the break.
Yeah, and I like the fact they didn't mess around with it once they got it.
Number 11. And that one's good.
That's how you exploit that defense. Take the ball right to the basket.
The basket's coming early and often in the first quarter. The Nuggets on top. They're up by 4. And the second quarter will get underway just after this short break. And now the second quarter just getting set to start. And from what we've been watching, guys, with the Nuggets, what are you seeing out there?
And they've done a nice job here offensively to establish a rhythm and a pace to this game.
And I like that they're finding ways to score, playing well here, Steve.
Thing has been just great so far, up at 56%. All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade as the second quarter gets going. Six to shoot. Number four gets it to go from 18 feet away.
Something they'd like to see more of him more often, that's for sure.
Denver in the lead. Number 17 bangs home the trifecta. 5 points in the game. So it's the visitors now. Number 30 gets it to go.
Been a little too easy for them inside, hasn't it?
Yeah, I think so, Steve. I mean, they've really dictated the action in the paint. That's been their focus, and the defense hasn't mounted much resistance at all.
Here's Mitchell. The jump hook. Again, the Nuggets score.
Again, they attack the hoop from the lane, and it's been really good to them.
Yeah, they're getting whatever they want down there. That's four of their last five buckets coming in the paint area.
A minute and a half gone here in the second quarter. Five to shoot. And it's Denver with the rebound. Let's it go from 14.
Well, he has some real problems converting chances inside. I mean, even when there's not much defense there, whatever defense is there is soft.
Number four, off the mark from 16 feet out. The Nuggets leading by five. 17-foot shot on the way. Gone 2-4 shooting the ball here in the second. One's good.
I'm sure they'd like to get more shots like that one.
Quarter two and just under 2.5 minutes gone by. It's up a three. Shot is no good. Gone three of their first five shots to drop here in the second quarter. To the paint, number 15. And he finishes nicely on the layup. Now just a one-point Nugget lead.
Yeah, we're now starting to see them get some high-percentage shots in the paint.
Yeah, that's five of their last six buckets inside the lane, so they're getting really high-percentage looks down there.
Number 16, that's good. 8 points for him. So it's the visitors now. Get six. Here's Spencer. And his first shot of the game, no good. The Nuggets leading by three. From 10 feet out. And the shot is good.
Carving them up inside there, Kevin. I mean, the defense has been vulnerable in there.
Yeah, that's three straight field goals in the paint area. That's really good offense.
Down low. That's good.
Boy, a nice little trend developing here, fellas. I mean, that's eight of their last 10 from inside the paint.
Yeah, they're getting high percentage looks down there. Their offense is really clicking. I don't see why they wouldn't just continue to pound the ball inside.
Denver with a platoon swap here on the floor. Nuggets have gone 4 of 7 from the field in the second quarter so far. Some nice ball movement by the Nuggets. Gets it to go. And the Nuggets lead by 5. Gone 5 of 8 from the floor here in the second quarter. Over 60% shooting. Number 4. Offline from the high post. The Nuggets leading by 5. Tries a 3. The shot no good.
Boy, the defense just backing off, begging him to take that shot.
Number 7. That's blocked. Inside, number 5, count the bucket, and it's a 7-point Nugget lead.
Something has to change, guys. That's 10 straight points coming in the paint against this team.
Well, they got to collapse in there, and everybody's got to be conscious of it. It's a team effort in protecting the paint. Control the ball, and then everybody's got to get in there and keep the defense locked down.
They are in attack mode right now. That's 10 straight points, guys, all coming inside the paint.
And Steve, if I'm them, I keep going right to the heart of that defense like they have been until they do something about it. If they don't offer resistance, take everything you can get in there.
Six on the shot clock. Number 4. Can't hit. And Denver the other way now. Number 11. And he can't extend the lead to double digits. 45% in quarter number 2. Number 4. Drains the J off the nimble drop step. He has 6.
Just too easy. They're getting whatever they want down there.
You said it, Steve. 5 straight field goals inside for him. The defense has to clamp down here.
So it's Denver now. Number 4. No good with the elbow jumper. Number 13. That's good. The Nuggets leading by 5. 1:15 left in the second quarter. Good.
Well, that was the only way he was going to get that shot off. The leaner with his man all over.
The away team will take their first timeout of the game.
He did not look too happy about some of the things he saw on the court. So I would expect some changes here.
I think it's the right move, quite honestly. I mean, they just didn't look sharp or at their best out there. So take the timeout and give yourself a chance to regroup.
.106 left to play in the first half. Number 5. Puts up the runner and hits.
No question, they're trying to pound the ball inside. That's 5 straight hoops inside.
And if the D won't stop it, keep at it. I mean, those are the kind of looks you want all day long.
So it's Denver now. Leading by 5. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot 2. The Nuggets shooting their first free throws of the game.
Number 14. At the line for 2.
First free throw is good. And the Nuggets making a change here. Good on both. 40 seconds left in the first half. Number 13. No one on him, and he makes the easy one.
You know, if their plan was to keep going inside a ton, it sure has paid off. I mean, it seems like every bucket they get is in the lane.
Well, no reason to take an outside shot if you're scoring at will from inside the paint.
And it's the Nuggets with the ball. It's a five-point game. And they turn it over, stepped in the line that time.
Boy, that's embarrassing, guys. He's going to have a hard time putting that one down later when they watch it on tape.
The visitors with the ball. With 4 seconds on the clock, number five. That's good. He's got six. He knocks it down, but wait a minute. The officials are getting together. They may want to review this one. And the teams are going to have to wait before heading to the locker room. They're going to bring out the monitor and see if he got that shot off in time.
You know, I've always felt that video review was a great addition to the NBA rules, especially when it could have such an impact on the outcome of a game.
I agree, Clark, and very tough to tell on this one. We don't see a lot of these reviews, but a good percentage of reviews ultimately end up in an overturned ruling of what was originally thought to be a basket or not.
The Clippers. And they've seen enough. The basket will not count. The quarter has come to an end before the shot.
Still important to have a second look at it, Kevin. I mean, the technology's available, so you might as well use it.
Absolutely. And the first half ends in a close one. Nuggets lead by three. And coming up after the break, it'll be Damon Bruce breaking down all the highlights from the first half of play.
And now, brought to you by Sprint.
Thanks for joining us at halftime. We got a terrific game going on at Pepsi Center. The Nuggets are battling hard in this one. They're racking up the assists, great passing in the early going. And slugging it out so far are the visitors. They've done a great job closing out their defensive possessions, grabbing boards, great rebounding. And that'll be it for us here. Thanks so much for joining me. Now it's time to head back to Kevin Harlan, Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and Doris Burke. We hope to see you around next time.
Allow me to reintroduce myself. And now the start of the second half. Neither side jumping out ahead through the first two quarters. About 59% from the floor offensively, they've been running without a hitch. Number seven. It's hauled in by the Nuggets. Their biggest lead of the game was nine. To the inside. Ball stolen. Two on none, no one back to stop this. And for the Nuggets, gets it to go. He's got eight.
Boy, they were not wasting any time on that fast break.
Well, when it starts with a turnover, that's the best time to get out and run. You can beat the defense down the floor that way.
And it's the Nuggets with the ball. They lead by one. Can't hit the free throw line jump.
And a missed opportunity right there.
Definitely, I think he should have converted that one.
Pocket six. Number five for the lead. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here. It's his first trip to the line. That free throw missing. And it's tied up with that one.
Well, despite tying things up, he's still shaking his head, knowing he could have given them the lead.
To the middle. Good look. Good. He has five.
That's four straight field goals coming inside the paint.
Boy, they're taking it right to him, Steve, and the defense has really been way too passive for my liking.
Number 11. The shot is off. Now Denver takes it the other way. It's intercepted. Into the third we go. 2 minutes in now. Right around him with the drop step.
Brought back the finger roll. That's a nice finesse move to pull off with the defense all over.
Time call here. The Nuggets decide to talk it over. Guys, we have seen them with a lot of good ball movement.
Well, you like the smooth operating they're showing you here. I mean, things are clicking, and more importantly, it makes them tough to defend.
There's no agenda. The ball's just moving to whoever is open, and as a result, they've kind of developed a clicking kind of pace to their game. It's been fun to watch.
Just under 2.5 minutes into the third quarter now. And it's Denver with the rebound. Down low. They get a hand on it. Off they go on a 3-on-1 break. Number 5. Shot's good. He's got 9.
Another turnover, another bucket.
And you know, Steve, turnovers can really be game changers. I mean, they sap your team and then give the other team life. So it's a double-edged sword.
Good.
Second half is flowing nicely so far on offense. 75% from the field is what they're shooting.
Inside. And the basket good.
It takes a lot of skill and agility to lay it in with the defense right on you. That's a terrific finish.
To the inside. The Nuggets moving the ball around. Number 7. And Denver again with the bucket.
Well, they really picked up the intensity here since halftime.
I think they got the pep talk in both teams now, really going after each other.
Number 4. Wide open, couldn't capitalize.
You know, as tight as this game is, you have to like their chances the way they've been rebounding.
They have a pretty good margin in that department, so they've got to continue to hit the boards hard. It'll pay off for them in the end.
Going an even 50% from the floor here in the third quarter. 4 of 8. So it's both teams making substitutions here. Dishes it to Hamilton. Fires top of the key. Can't get it to go.
Yeah, that's a low percentage shot right there.
Yeah, it sure is. I mean, he's got to be thinking out there a little bit. Make the pass in that situation. Don't force a bad shot.
Around 44% in this third quarter. Oh, Hamilton, right side. They can't stop the run with that one. The Nuggets leading by 7. Let's it go from 14. Stepped in the line, out of bounds there, and that will cost them the possession. Both teams deciding to change it up. Being 55% from the floor, they're feeling very confident offensively. High post try, no good. Now Denver takes it the other way. To the paint. Inside and stolen by Hamilton. Here's Brown. Gets the bucket. Brown's got his first 2 points.
Turnover problems for them, and they just look lackluster out there.
Yeah, sometimes you have off games, but you always have to bring the effort, and I'm not sure I'm seeing that right now.
Here's the break. Number 7 buries it down low. Now it's just a 3-point Nugget lead. 1:50 left in the third quarter of the game. Number 5, covered by Hamilton. Hits from the high post. 12 points for him. Gone at a pretty good shooting pace. They're 6-13 from the field here in the third. So both teams making some changes here. Number 11. A picture-perfect screenplay, and the jumper's good.
And guys, 10 of their last 12 points coming in the paint.
Yeah, I like their aggressiveness on offense, but the question is, where's the defense? They've got to put up some resistance here.
And so here's Denver. Number 14. Again, the Nuggets score. So it's the visitors now, trailing by 5. Number 13. The shot misses. Now Denver takes it the other way.
Another board just continuing to add to that big rebound margin.
And it's a bit ironic, guys. I mean, you would think the score wouldn't be so close the way they're dominating the glass. But this one is still in the balance.
Look at their scoring. Mid-range jumpers account for 6 of their last 10 points.
Well, defensively, they're doing a nice job of keeping them out of the paint. But got to give them credit. They're knocking down shots.
That free throw, no good. He hits the second from the line. There's 38 seconds left in the third. Number 11. And there's another one for the Nuggets.
They haven't been as aggressive from outside as they were in the first half. They're playing smart with the lead. I like that. They're being very selective and deliberate in their offense. And that's a good strategy when you're on top.
Now here is Hamilton. Guarded close. Number 11. No good on the buzzer beater. And that's it for the third quarter. Both teams scoring well as we head to the fourth. Nuggets ahead, leading by 8. And do not go away as we'll be back in just a few moments with the start of our fourth quarter coming up next. As the fourth quarter gets rolling here, let's check out our Sprite Uncontainable Game. Let's go to Doris Burke. Hi, Doris.
Kev, the Nuggets have had the uncontainable game in this one. No big errors on their part, and they've been the team that wants it more so far. It's that extra bounce in their step that has been the difference maker for them.
Thank you, Doris. The Nuggets leading by 8. Number 5. And the ball goes out of play following this shot.
Clippers ball. Number 13.
Being one of the high points for them in this game at 54%. Shot from 16. No good. And the Nuggets going the other way.
They keep pounding them on the glass here in this one. Just a tremendous job rebounding the ball.
Well, that's half the battle. I mean, you go after it every single time. It's a mindset. Never assume the shot's going in. You've got to always assume the shot's going to come off the rim, and it's going to be yours.
So both teams changing it up here. Hamilton, right side. Six to shoot. Feeds it to Brown. High post shot. It's hauled in by the Nuggets. 1 minute now into this fourth quarter. Let's it go. And another miss by Denver. Pass to Hamilton. Passes it to Brown. From the top of the key, no luck. The Nuggets leading by 11. And we've made our way through just over a minute and a half in this fourth quarter.
You know, even though he's bite-sized compared to the big man on the floor, he's done some really tall work on the boards.
They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin, the offense has basically been running in place.
They got to get going.
And this continues to be a shootout.
Well, I'm a fan as well as a commentator, and I love this fast-paced action. I mean, it's going back and forth, back and forth.
Both teams deciding to change it up. Second minute off the clock now in the fourth. Number 14. That's good. And the Nuggets lead by 10.
Good work turning that into an easy 2-point. He can attack the rim as well as anybody. Well, we've seen with most of the big-name stars that ended up steering their way to new teams and ended up getting a sign and trade in the case of Carmelo Anthony or Chris Paul. But after this season, that sign and trade door will, in essence, be shut. And we'll see what effect that has on the game.
Let's find out what Doris Burke has for us.
Hi, Kevin. The head coach for the visiting team had some instruction for his guys during that last break. He let his players know that they've got to do a better job on defense. He said, they're scoring any way they want. We've got to show some pride here. Let's make a stand defensively, get us stops, and get on a run of our own. Do they have it in them, Kevin?
And Clark, you mentioned the changes in the sign and trade. In essence, players can't get more money in a sign and trade than they could signing with the other team outright.
Yeah, and the reason they can't make more money, Clark, is because they can't sign the full 5-year deal that they used to be able to. Now in a sign and trade, you can only sign the 4-year contract. And that's that means that players are going to be more incentivized just to stay in their original place.
Gets it to go.
Yeah, not just an everyday finish. He put a little pizzazz on that one, guys.
Hamilton outside.
wide open. And it's Denver with the rebound.
Solid job by them on the glass here tonight. +8 in rebounding.
Well, you have to rebound to win, and that's exactly what's happening right now.
Number 7. Oh, that's blocked.
At the line, here go the Nuggets. Number 7. Two shots.
And he makes the first. And so he makes both from the line. And a little over 3.5 minutes in the books so far here in the fourth. Number 11 gets the bucket.
You gotta love the low post offense. That was beautiful.
Denver calls timeout.
That was a good time to call the timeout to try to settle everybody down and get back into their offensive rhythm. They've been coughing up the rock an awful lot.
The Nuggets leading by 8. Number 7. And another miss by Denver. Gun just under 45% of their attempts to drop in the fourth of 9. And that one's good. Nuggets have gotten only 3 of their 9 field goal attempts to go down since the end of the third. Pretty cold down the stretch. Number 14. And unable to corral the miss, and it goes out of play.
Number 4.
Gone 5 of 10, 50% from the field. From 16, the shot will not go. And the Nuggets going the other way. Tries it from 9. And again, Denver no good. About 45% from the 4 in the fourth. Shot clock at 6. Number 7. Hit his leg. And the ref saying he kicked it. Six to shoot. Number 11. And that one's good. They got on this roll a while ago and they just haven't looked back. The Nuggets shooting indicative of smooth offensive play. Up at 60%, they're a machine from the floor. Number 11 gets it to go from 8 feet.
You know, role players can make big differences in games, and he's showing he can get it done out there.
Number 5. And it's Denver with the rebound. They've led by as many as 11 points. With the drop step. Good on the shot. And it's an 8-point Nugget lead.
Well, he wants to get everybody on the same wavelength, that's for sure. He may change up some things here as well.
Looks to me like he saw something that wasn't on the plan. And think now is the time to address it. I don't have a problem with that.
1:37 left in the fourth quarter. Number 11. And he drops it in from the low post. He's got 19. The Nuggets leading by 6. Drop steps. And it's Denver scoring again.
Boy, they've been getting a lot of their points on those mid-range jumpers.
Now, that's a shot that can come and go. Not an easy shot, but they're doing a nice job knocking them down.
Locking 6. Shot, no good. Now the Nuggets take it the other way. Number 14, and Denver again with the bucket.
And that should definitely do it. Now it's starting to get out of hand.
Yeah, they're not just running to the finish line, they're running through the finish line right here. They're piling on a bit.
That's his fourth, so he's going to have to be very careful the way he plays and pick his spots here in the second half.
There's 49 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Elbow shot. Good as the jump shot falls. Nuggets have gone 7-15 from the floor here in the fourth. Right around 46-47%. Number 11. Good. And the Nuggets lead by 10.
And this one is just about over. It's going to be an easy win for them in the end.
Yep, I think they can just about put this one on cruise control for the last few seconds here.
And that one's good.
Looks like this one's over. They really played well tonight.
Yep, I agree with you. I mean, we can take it out of the oven. This game is cooked.
On the run, but he made the adjustment. We've got 22 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. To the middle, number 13. Drops in the layup for 2.
I like the awareness they had there. Guys were headed out on the break the instant the steal was made.
And they got the easy bucket because of
the triple. Can't get it to go. So the Nuggets win it. It was a solid win, Clark.
Yeah, it was, and I think it came down to will more than skill. They went out and got this one.
That about does it for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke, and the rest of our great crew. This is Kevin Harlan saying so long, and thanks for watching. Now, here is our Jordan Player of the Game.